Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Big Benedict. I'm bringing you Chapter 7 of Ninja Gaiden Sigma, number 1, on Master Ninja difficulty, excuse me. So this is the Monastery, and right off the bat, you may be saying to yourself, hey, wait a minute, Big, what the fuck, an hour-long video? Well, it could have been longer. It really could have been longer. An hour-long video, that's probably about 5 hours of my time, because it takes a few hours to record a chapter. Editing takes at least an hour, and then, you know, recording, it takes real time, because I'm actually sitting here speaking and watching the video again. So I might not stick around the whole video. I might divvy up my participation in this video, but the main reason this video is almost an hour, and there's going to be a couple where they're almost an hour long, probably a little more sometimes, is because these chapters are very involved, and the Fiend Challenge takes a long, long time, and it could have probably been about 25 or 30 minutes less than it is if I didn't include the Fiend Challenge, or if I did the same thing as last time, if I just fast-forwarded it. But I didn't find that to be too enjoyable to speak over when I was doing it. But these cat fiends, these are the hardest enemies in the game. That's just my opinion. The most annoying enemy in the game is the ghost fish. So the ghost fish, the most annoying, the hardest, these fucking cat fiends. I hate these guys. They pretty much break your guard every single time, and I don't ever think I've counterattacked these guys or even wanted to, but I have the armlet of the moon equipped, and I'm just getting torn to shreds most of the time when I'm fighting these guys. It's just ridiculous. But if you stay in that little archway, you can kind of control the spawn a little bit, because they don't seem to cross the threshold much. You see over there where the archway is behind me? You can look at, if you do cause these guys to spawn them and run back, they'll disappear, and you can't, like, kill a couple, make them disappear, have them respawn. They just start to count over. So I'm gonna be getting the Diabolocro in this guide. This is probably the most intense chapter of all. You notice I switched to the Lunar. I also upgraded it off camera to level 2. That's because we're facing the, and I apologize for these loading screens, I can't do anything about it. If I edited out every single one, I'd be driving myself crazy. But we're going to be facing the first Ryu clone over here, and I discovered this little trick on my own. I had no idea how to do this, and then I discovered it on accident, a complete trick to dealing with these Ryu clones. And pretty much every time I face them, I'm going to take the coward's way out. And that's just because I don't enjoy fighting these guys whatsoever. They're cheap, they're not fun, and you have to face about 5 or 6 of these guys throughout the campaign. They appear on hard mode up, so if you're playing normal, you're not going to encounter them. But if you do play hard mode and up, you're going to be facing these fucking bastards. I hate these guys so much, and I never miss an opportunity to be cheap on them, because all they do is cheap tricks. That's all they do. So I'm going to implement a really cheap trick of my own, and go up on this little platform up here. See, I fell. This is also the area where there's a huge fiend challenge, and I'm going to be doing the whole fiend challenge of cat fiends and red ninjas. So all you need to do is go up here and just stay put here and knock this guy back down with the lunar staff. I still don't have the armlet of the sun. I don't find any use for the armlet of the sun. I don't even know if it takes that much more damage away. You know, it's kind of the same thing as, like, your hit damage getting protected with the armlet of the moon. I just don't know. But if that guy does get up there, you do have to get into a real good streak of getting this guy down. See how cheap this guy is? See how cheap he is? Look at this shit. So, this could either work really well for you, as it did for me here, but it took a couple of times to actually make this work well. A lot of the times he'll just get up here, but you could pretty much knock him down, and I pretty much kept him off this platform from this point on until he dies. So it's really effective. And this is the best weapon to use on this guy. You see, he almost got up right there, but I knocked him back down. I hate these guys so much. You know, if I don't find enjoyment in something, then I don't like to do it. The things that I take pleasure in, those are the things that I really take my time to narrate and go over. But this is not fun. I hate when you fight this guy. Every time he has a different weapon, he's always got tricks up his sleeve. So you just never know. I think he's got unlimited use of his ninpo. He throws incendiary shurikens like they're going out of style. It's really bad. So you can normally just wall span this guy to victory, and that's what I did a couple times before on some of the later versions of him. So he's down, and he gets you quite a bit of money too. So also we're gonna be getting those incendiary shurikens. So let's see, I got 1,000 bucks, almost 2,000 bucks, and when I got the orb, so, actually, he didn't give us that much money, he gave us like 5,000 bucks. So I'm just going to be grabbing these novels off the bookcase, since I am a bibliophile myself. I used to be anyway, I don't like to read much anymore, just kind of lost the patience for it, but I used to read a lot. Anyway, so there's a couple of items in these display cases here. Spiritual life right there. And I just slashed all of them. Anyway, so I think there's a golden scarab in one of them. That one right there. So that's cool. And so I'm going to be backtracking. I would recommend getting the Diabolico early on in this game. It's really helpful in the Fiend Challenge. So that armlet of potency, I don't think that's a good armlet whatsoever. All it does is increase your kick damage or your grabbing damage. Completely waste of, you know, a space. What they really need on this game is an armlet that allows you to have two slots. Because there's so many times when I want to have the armlet of Benediction equipped and the armlet of Celerity equipped to expedite my charges and also get more money. So that'd be really good. They need an armlet with two slots on it. So that's another drawback of this game. So I'm going to head on out of this room. I think this is the Life of the Gods right here. And the other chest has a smoke bomb. Not sure if I passed it up knowing what it was. So I'm going to be backtracking right now after I save it. And go get the Diabolico because we can access the door with the crack on it in the back in Tyrod. Now that we have incendiary shuriken. So you notice I'm not going to waste anyone's time by doing all this in real time. So I sped this all up. I often do this. Just to spare everybody the tedium of me backtracking. You know, there's no fun of watching somebody just backtrack, so I have the wherewithal to do this, so I might as well do it, you know? And I guess I did do these battles here. So, so this is the area where I'm going to go get the item, the Diabolico. I really like the Diabolico. It's a great weapon. It's a really good weapon. It has a ton of horizontal splash damage to it, so when you're hitting enemies in a straight line, you could pretty much hit an enemy like real close to you, and you can also hit an enemy like clear across the screen. So I'm going to be relying on that to take care of the Fiend Challenge. And so I think on the Fiend Challenge I'll narrate just the relevant parts, and then it gets to the point where I'm just doing the same thing over and over and over again. So there's no real point of me just sticking around. I do have other things to do. You know, I don't just sit in my chair all day and do this stuff. Although I do spend quite a bit of time on this because it's fun. This is really fun stuff to do. But it does get kind of, you know, tedious at some points. This is a really tedious game. But I like it a lot. It's a hell of a good game. I'd rather be playing this than, you know, anything else that's out there right now. Resident Evil 6. That game can go fuck itself, in my opinion. I don't even care about that game. I care about this game. But there is a point where you do get sick to your stomach of playing a game, so let's hope that doesn't happen. Anyway, so it doesn't aim too well, but aim right there. Grab the Diabolico. And you could also do a nice little wall run up here. And it's surprising that that weapon's just in that box. It's a nice little fit inside that box, huh? Really, the geometry really works well for that situation. So do a wall run over here, and I didn't know if I was gonna make that, but I did. So a jewel of the demon seal. They do give you enough of these seals to upgrade every single one of your magic spells, but you do want to be careful about wasting one. There's no respec feature like in Dead Space where you could unapply it out of, you know, the magic. You can't once you commit to an upgrade and save it. That's it. You don't get another chance. So. If you do, you know, upgrade something you don't want to, just make sure you allow yourself to be killed and then restart. Unless you're going to waste a lot of progress. But getting back to what I was saying, you can upgrade every single item in this game. Every single one of your upgrades, it just takes a little while. And they don't give you the final one till the the Art of the Inazuma, which is my personal favorite. Yeah, some of these Nimpo, they just don't work very well on bosses. That's what I don't really like too much. I wish the bosses were a little more susceptible to Nimpo, but the ones that are susceptible, you got to be grateful, you know, that they're at least doing that shit. So I think I fast forward this footage over here. Yep, and probably avoid every one of these battles because I grinded for money as much as I needed to over in that one area that I pointed out before in a previous video. So now we're heading on back to the Fiend Challenge, and you want to make sure you have, I think I have two Talismans of Rebirth, but I don't even think I needed one Talisman of Rebirth. So this is the Fiend Challenge, and it's not hard whatsoever. If you do it my way, if you want to, you know, I don't think it's possible for anyone to do this without any cheap methods. Just like that night, the 120 nightmares, I don't think anyone could, I don't think that's humanly possible to do that without being really cheap. These enemies should spawn over here in a second. You know what? I may have spoken too soon. I think I have to do a couple more things before this Fiend Challenge spawns. Yep, it hasn't spawned yet. I forgot. Completely my bad, but I wanted to point out that this door over here, see this door with the crack on it? You could use these incendiary shurikens, but you could also use a Dabalacro. And do not fight this fight right here. It's horrible. The fight you need to do is it's so fucking hard. It's so hard. It's ridiculous. You have to fight these sorcerers, these flying sorcerers, cats, and red ninjas in this room over here. So, the combination is, I think it's 21-12 or something. I may have edited that incorrectly, I'm sorry. I'm not re-editing this footage, it took forever. It takes a video like this, it's gonna take a whole day to upload. I'm not kidding, literally a whole day, from, at the time I started. It's gonna take 24 hours. These are huge ass files, and it takes up a huge amount of space on my hard drive. It's because of the resolution of this game and the frame rate. It's a big game. This game is huge. Normally when I, so I don't know. Let me just talk about this here. This fight is ridiculous. I would recommend going to town with Nimpo and doing these sorcerers. I don't think they really are prone to getting fly swallowed very well. So you really need to use your Nimpo. You need to throw. They do allow you to stick incendiary shurikens into them, which is good. And they take a couple of those to kill. This cat, that was a nice victory there. This is a very hard room, and they really punish you for getting that damn book in the safe. So what I was saying was, I was recording God of War recently, and that game, the PS3 version of that game on the PS3, the HD remaster copy, those versions, they don't take much of my resources whatsoever. I could actually render like up a couple of videos and still record footage without any lag. But that's not the case with this game. If I have a one of these videos, like for instance, if this was rendering, there's no way I could play the game because I would get way too much lag. And I have like a $1,600 computer. I paid way too much for it. I definitely paid the price for all the speed that I have. But I got a very fast rig. But it's still, this game requires a lot of hard disk space, and I have to put everything on an external hard drive, and it's a very big project. But the God of War videos, those are no problem. It's because that game is really old, and even on the PS3, even the remaster copies, it still doesn't take much resources up. So I think I even had 3 files rendering at once, and I still was playing that game with no lag. But I can't even do one file here, so I usually have to just have all these rendering while I'm sleeping. So then when I wake up, they're finished. It's just crazy. This game, it's a biggin, definitely a biggin. So we're gonna head on back in here, and I got the Dabalacro, and you can't upgrade it to the second strength. It just doesn't let you, not in this stage anyway. So this is on the very first strength, and as you're going in here, I'm gonna hit the L2 button to bring up the karma screen to get the kill count. Because fortunately, we could actually do the kill count here. So you see this this situation what we have here. We have a bunch of cats running around, and that red ninja throwing shit at us. So You're very safe up on that balcony up there. In fact, if you go up on that balcony where I was dealing with that Ryu clone, none of these enemies will get you. None of them will jump up there, which is kind of a bad thing because it makes it less easy. But the way I'm going to show you how to do this is so easy. So what's going on here is you kind of get overwhelmed at first. You really need to take out a couple of these guys. And right off the bat here, I do get overwhelmed because there's quite a few enemies. And there's only one red ninja at a time over here. But the cats, they spawn like in packs. So what you need to do here is, surprisingly, these red ninjas go down with a few hits from the windmill shuriken. You see how this guy, like, half a dozen shots and he's dead? And then I'm going to start charging essence. I'm going to be chaining essence this whole time. But first I'm going to have to you really have to get into the groove of this. And I would recommend having the Davalocro equipped. And you see, this started to work really well over here. So all you need to do is do red UT off these guys, and then chain attacks off the dropped essence. What ends up happening here, it happened the same time last time. You're just going to get one cat running up every single time. And you're going to have one red ninja at the bottom who doesn't come up. He just kind of stays at the bottom, like, trapped. And I don't know if it's because of where I'm standing. It really has to be the place I'm standing because I think he gets trapped in this spot. And I discovered this at random, you know, this just testing how to do this. So, this takes a very long time, but if you want to get the Spirit of the Devils, this is what you're going to have to do. It actually doesn't take as long as the Nightmare Challenge, I imagine, would take. I don't think I'm ever going to do that challenge. It's just, that would probably take like 5 hours to accomplish. So I have the Armlet of the Moon equipped with the Diabolocro, and you see I'm just chaining essence, and these cats are just going to be running up the stairs one at a time here. And I think the cat count and the red ninja count is 60 and 60, so that is totaling the 120 kill count you need. So once you kill a bunch of the cats at first, as you saw me do, then you just have one cat running up the stairs at a time. It's actually really funny at first, you know, and it gets to the point where you're not smiling anymore. You're just saying, hurry the fuck up. But, all we have here is one cat running up the stairs to us every time, whom we're greeting with a red UT kill. And we have a red ninja down there just getting trapped, throwing incendiary shurikens that never hit us. So, this goes on forever. And, I think I'm going to end it right here and come back on into the picture when the red ninja starts spawning, because then it is a little bit more involved, but it's basically the same exact thing. But sometimes you can't kill the red ninjas in one hit unless you get direct contact with them. So, and also, having the Armlet of the Sun equipped for those red ninjas, it doesn't slay them with any like more efficiency. So it doesn't even matter. I would definitely have the Armlet of the Moon equipped here. I'm going to have that thing equipped for probably the whole game. I don't see any reason not to. You just get dealt way too much damage in this game. So if there are any instances where I need that Armlet of the Sun equipped, I'll probably use it. The really good thing about this is that you get about 50,000 bucks for this whole, for all these essence chains. And because when you're absorbing the essence to use your next attack, you do get a lot of the money. When I say lot, it just adds up over a lot of kills. You probably don't get that much. You probably get like 250 bucks or so. But, you know, times that by 120, and I'm horrible with math, and that was just a guess. But I have no idea. But I'm going to head on out of here and come back when the Red Ninja spawns. So I'm going to leave you, but don't worry. You don't need me to hold your hand here, because it's the same thing over and over and over again. If things go awry, just drop Dimpo, you know, for a second of a piece. So I'm gonna duck on out of here now. Yeah. Okay, so that's 60 cats that we've killed, and it looks like there are more than 60 cats. I'm not really sure, unless, you know, there were a couple more red ninjas that we killed. I would imagine, I don't see any, yeah, there probably are 60 and 60, so now the red ninjas are coming up here, and these guys, it's a little bit of a different strategy involved, but all you need to do is charge off a red UT, like right there. And you see how I didn't kill that guy, so all I need to do is hit the score button just a couple of times and then backtrack here. Normally you end up waiting on these guys, so you're not really pressured to get back into this little hiding spot over here underneath the balcony. So it just depends. It's kind of random. Sometimes I release the button at the same time, and sometimes it doesn't kill them, sometimes it does. So I think if you wait to release the button a little bit longer, then you get in a kill, but having the Omelet of the Sun here, it doesn't guarantee a kill. I mean, it doesn't do more hit damage, so things can really get kind of get tense. But these guys only spawn like one on one here, so it's just the same situation. It's just except that these guys have more HP, obviously. So that's why you see a couple of times I get hit, and you're gonna get knocked off your feet a couple of times. All you need to do is just try to recover the best you can. Have at least maybe a Talisman of Rebirth to back you up going into this. I had two, or maybe just one. I know I had at least one. But so I'll be sticking around for the rest of this video. But so there's 30, and then, or excuse me, 70. So what's that? 30. We need 50 more times for this. Wow. This is really tedious, just to get a Spirit of the Devils. But, I don't mind doing this. It didn't take very long. I think it took about a half an hour in real time. Maybe a little bit longer. I'm not real sure. But they go down pretty quickly. And towards the end, I try to wall run, and I fall down to the part of the main area of the archives. So you see how much damage I'm getting taken away. It's ridiculous on Master Ninja mode. But, you got to expect that. And I don't know. I think it is just one-on-one at this point. Even if you headed on down to the main area, it would just be one-on-one. But, when you get this far involved in the challenge, you don't want to die. But I've never had to use a Talisman of Rebirth here. I did, on this instance, have to use all 5 of my potions and all 2 of my greater potions here. But when I did this before, I had a couple of potions left, too, so I didn't even have to waste all my potions either. So all you do, this is pretty easy. But it can be pretty. You do get a little nervous. I got a little nervous some of the times. You see, they just don't get killed. As this trial progresses, I do delay releasing the button a little bit longer. I think that was more effective, but it's random. It's got to be random. I don't know how to control how to kill these guys with the getting more a direct of a hit. So, once you hit them with the red UT, that they're almost dead at that point. So they just need a couple of chops and they're dead. And the Dabalocra is such a powerful weapon; it's just crazy. And you don't really need to hustle your ass back over here. See, normally you're just waiting on these guys, and you're glancing at your wristwatch and saying, hurry up, get your ass over here." It's very manageable. This is what I would consider a very manageable and fair trial, a very doable trial. So this is the point where I started to have the camera pan away from me as an indication that these guys were coming, and that was causing me to release the button a little later. So I think I got a couple of kills with direct contact, but it's not perfect, and I'm not perfect, and you're not going to be perfect either. So, just complete the task. That's all you have to do. So that was maybe not. But normally that little animation means that they're killed. This looks like a huge baseball bat this guy has. It's crazy. It's a good weapon. It's really fast too. Surprisingly, for a double-handed sword, it's really quick. I think if you're hitting them just as they're about to hit you, you kind of hit them with the sword and also with the red UT. Sometimes I think if you're hitting them with the splash damage, I seem to recall getting a lot more kills off the bat, automatic kills, than this. I guess it was a little later on into the trial, but so there is a direct contact kill. That was good, and if you want the most money, you just want to grab the essence without absorbing it and rechaining it for more essence. To expedite your charge. You normally can get a red UT starting from scratch in this corner, and you're still waiting on these guys normally. There is a direct kill. So, it's just kind of funny. It's funny at first. I'm not laughing now, obviously, but it's just a funny situation here. I wish there was a better way to deal with the nightmare trials. Killing 120 of those guys, man, that's just, it's ridiculous. I have seen a video of someone do it. They were doing a technique just like this one. They're standing in a corner where the nightmares weren't crossing the line. It's after you slay Doku for the first time. No, excuse me. Yeah, it is the first time you slay him. In a later chapter, right after the Aqueduct, it is the Aqueduct chapter boss, the stage after that, I think after you do Rachel, no pun intended, but after, it's before the Spirit Doku fight, so it's in between that. It's really all good. This is a fun game. I really want to give a lot of shout-outs to everybody who's watching. There's this one dude named and I'm not gonna say his. I'll say his username. It's not a breach of anything. His name is Pure something 79. He's from another country. He's a really cool dude. He gives me so much respect. He says like my videos are the best. I gotta give that guy, you know, a shout out. That guy is a really good guy. I gotta say thanks for the support, and I will leave an annotation in the video with his real name. I have clicked on his profile, and I saw some text in another language, so he's obviously from another country. I'm in the U.S., but that kind of support is really, really nice. He brightened my day a couple times, and a lot of people out there giving me a lot of support. P. Riley, I got to give a shout-out to that guy. Raskolnikov, all my buddies on YouTube. Just a lot of people that hang around in my videos. And, you know, this is all for fun. It's fun and games. But it does kind of... I do take it to a real serious degree sometimes. Me and I had a lot of competition with my brother sometimes. We really try to earn bragging rights and stuff. And we're kind of on an honor system where if I say I beat Master Ninja Mode, he just takes my word for it because I'm a pretty damn serious gamer. Normally, sometimes I play for fun. Like, I've been playing Spec Ops The Line for fun recently. I'm not going to do a guide for that game. But I have been playing that game, and that was pretty fun. So sometimes I just play a game. I don't want to do a guide for it. But he's been playing Resident Evil 6, and you know, that's cool. He likes it, and that's all good. If you like a game, that's fine. Don't listen to the critics say it's shit. Maybe it is shit. I don't know. But if it's not to him, then it's not. You know. But yeah, this is like I said, all fun and games. But I do take it way too seriously sometimes, and you know, who knows, it may actually benefit me. But the one thing that was really hilarious here was I fell down a little bit later on in this trial, so almost done with this, got 106 kills, and it gets pretty old pretty quickly here. But hopefully people that don't know how to do this trial will find my video and get some help. Maybe I'll put a couple of keywords in the tags so people can find it. There's a lot of competition on YouTube. A lot of more competition if you're doing new games. Like if I did a Resident Evil 6 guide, there's no way. It would probably be on page 100, my guide, or far even farther down. It's just like, and I don't even like that game. So like a game like this, a year from now or 2 years, I'll probably be on the first or second page. So, you know, be able to help a lot of people. And I don't really care about views and, you know, being seen. It is cool to get a lot of views, but mainly I just want people to find my videos, you know, in this sea of videos on YouTube. This, you know, this huge ocean of videos where you can just get really buried. But you see, I fell down there. I'm like, fuck, shit. I got really pissed when I fell because I knew it was inevitable. You know, you can only be so precise with the left analog stick, and this game has very good controls, but sometimes you mess up, and that was all my bad. I'm not saying the game messed up, that was my fault. I got way too complacent there, but yeah, a game like the older the game, like the less competition you have to post videos, the better your search results, because not many people play this game on Master Ninja Mode. There's just not, I mean, it's so hard that people just, they don't like difficult stuff. They would rather play an easy game. They would rather play Resident Evil 6 with infinite ammo and do a guide and get a lot of views. And what does that get you? I don't know. You know, maybe some money if people are doing this for money. I'm not doing it for money. I already have a job that I get paid for. And it's not this job. This is not a job. It's just a hobby. So I take up a lot too much of my time sometimes, and I pay the price. Definitely pay the price when I have to recover when I get inundated with stuff. It's just, I hate it. So maybe I'll have to post videos at a less frequent basis or something. But damn, that was a nice kill right there. That should have been the final kill. That little downward jab right there. And that's the last guy right here. And I decided to tear that guy a new asshole right there. And so there's our prize right there, the Spirit of the Devils. And it's a nice prize. I'm doing this for, I did that not to show off, but I'm a very completionist person. I really have to complete everything. That's why I'm so anal about every damn thing in this game. And I'm also I try not to use too much profanity in my guides, also in case like there's some 16-year-old out there watching this in his living room or something with his mom walking around. You know, I try to keep it. Try not to swear too much. That also comes off as unprofessional sometimes. But swearing's it's acceptable on YouTube. They don't mind it too much. They just don't want you to have naked people on your channel or whatever. That's all good in the hood. But I try to keep it all. You know. PG-13 or whatever on here. Try not to swear too much, but sometimes when you're getting excited or you're getting pissed off, swearing's inevitable. So, I don't put explicit on my titles or anything. It's all good. So, we're doing a lot. This is a long chapter. This is a. There's a lot of things you don't have to do on this chapter. So, getting the double acro was optional. Doing that challenge is optional. So now we're gonna actually use the book that we got, and I fought these enemies and then died on them, respawned, and they never appeared again, even after I had restarted the game, because I actually wanted to face them. I don't know what happened. I don't think I killed them because I remember they slayed me after a couple of cats hit me, and I know there's a bunch of flying sorcerers around. I remember somebody pointed out that he's hesitating to jump. As if he's scared to jump down there. I think it's a loading screen issue. I don't think he's timid about jumping down that ladder there. Not after he's been jumping off the top of Han's bar, you know? I don't think whatsoever. So, there is a golden scarab over here, a save point, and a boulder sequence, which you're running into the camera. So it's pretty decent. And if you die on the boulder, they just restart you with a little damage off your health. So it's really reasonable. So you can only, and also you can get revived with the Talisman of Rebirth. So it's really ridiculous. So head on into this gate after you save it. I'm going to be showing you how to smash this door with. You don't need incendiary shurikens for these doors. Either this weapon, the Warhammer, or the incendiary shurikens. That's the only thing that matters here. So see this boulder here? We're on the corridor of doom here. So you want to just wall run over here. And you're allowed to screw up a couple of times, I think maybe twice. You want to hug the wall over on this one, and then on the next one. Then you want to jump. Excuse me, there's one, two, three of these falling pillars. And then let's see what you do. You want to hug the wall and then jump. And go to the right there. And then I think this one's going to the left. No, that they kind of trick you right there. That's a tough one. That's definitely a tough one. So I think that was the last one. And it's really decent. You can't dash jump. I forgot to mention that. You can't dash jump. You can only jump. So they don't let you have a little boost or anything. So you do want to save it over here in case you jump and die. That happens a couple of times. You are allowed to jump down, but there's some spots where you'll just fall down to your death over here. And what I like to do here is do a downward thrust right there, and then save some orbs to expedite a charge over here with these imps. And these are the highest iteration of the imps. I was watching one of my videos before and I misspoke. The ones with like the least amount of body armor, like the really thin ones, those are the first iteration. And then the ones that we fought with the Rachel stage on the chapter, not the chapter challenge, the fiend challenge in a couple chapters back when we first were Rachel, those are the second iteration with 120 of those guys, and these are the hardest ones. So these ones are horrible. They'll slide under you, trip you up, and you can't get out of it, out of the animation. So one of the times, one of these guys jabbed me clear off the platform. It was pretty funny, actually. So we actually do need to place the Holy Grail on that thing, so I interacted with that too soon. But over here are some hornets, and these guys aren't that difficult. You could do the Azuna drop on them, the combo that it is, not the body slam move. Excuse me, I need to get a drink of water. So that's the Azuna drop I was talking about. So the Azuna drop works on so many things that you should try it out. Some of the things you'd be surprised what you can actually get combo hits off the Azuna drop for. It's ridiculous. But these guys can deal quite a bit of damage to you if they get into packs and they all hit you. Just like those phantoms, those little ghost things that have populated this area. I think they're going to be... I'll show you the next time they appear. Those things can really damage you significantly. So there are a couple items on these ledges here. And you don't have to worry about getting them now. Although, I can't recall if I get them now. Yeah, I'd probably go ahead and get them. There's a golden scarab right there. Hard to miss since you're going to be doing this jump quite a bit. And there is a life of the gods up here too. So all you need to do is wall run here. The first time I ever played this game, I had really trouble with the platforming. Had a big trouble with platforming. Just because I didn't know how to do anything. It's so remarkable to think, like, how inexperienced a player can be on this game. At the outset, like, playing on normal mode, I didn't ever think I would be able to beat the game, ever. On normal mode. And here I beat normal mode, beat very hard, and I'm trying to beat this mode. It's ridiculous. It's also really fascinating to think how good a player you can get over time. Really good. And I'm not the best. I'm damn good, though. If I could be Master Ninja, you know, I will be a Master Ninja at this game. But right now, I'm a ninja in training, I guess you'd say. So over here, those are the phantoms I was talking about. So I think if you kill these guys, then the sliding imps appear. And I discovered a very good trick over here. No assistance looking on other people's guides. I don't do that shit. So these sliding imps... always look for spots where the enemies just don't seem to cross a certain line. And this area right over here, they'll just loiter right in front of you without attacking or anything. It's really ridiculous. So there's a lot of parts. There's a section in Tyran right outside of Han's bar where later I'm going to be standing in the alleyway. I've done tons of videos for this on my channel. If you want to search for it, it's in the money making tutorials. Big Benedict 1111 with 4 1s, not 5 1s. But I completely take advantage of the fact that there are these brutes in a later chapter that simply they won't go down the alleyway after a certain space, and it's like there's an invisible barrier between you and them. They can't hit you, but you can hit them. So you can get a ton of money on that stage. Especially with the Armlet of Benediction equipped. You can get a lot of money, and you can do it as many times as you want, and that's an area that I go back to time and time again to get 99999 money. That's the one thing I don't like about this game, having to backtrack and make money all the time. It's really cumbersome of a process. But yeah, this is a great spot to stand. There's several instances in this game where you can just stand in one spot, and there's an invisible line that the enemies simply won't cross. So if anyone knows of any other spots, I've definitely been interested in hearing them, and you know, maybe they'll be helpful for somebody else, because this is a programming error at its finest. You know, it's a programming error because whoever programmed the game, they didn't account for this instance of you standing in that area and having the enemies attack you. It's a simple logic deduction, and why not take advantage of it? I can understand how someone would overlook that when they're programming this game, because this is a huge game. It's ridiculous. You can backtrack anywhere practically, with some exceptions. You can't go back onto the plane that explodes from Chapter 3. And I think when you revisit the Hayabusa village later on in the game, I don't think you can backtrack all the way where the waterfall is. I was having a hard time doing that. But I'll have to double check that. I'm not completely certain about that. But you do want to grab this golden scarab over here, that little sill right there. And this is a great opportunity to make a ton of money on a couple of sections up here where the ritual room is. And you're going to be noticing a bunch of fast-forwarded footage up here, simply because I'm doing the same thing over and over and over again. And if I had left it in, this video would have been an hour and a half as opposed to almost being an hour. So that was a complete accident right there, interacting with the ledge, with the ladder. But we're okay. So our goal right now, we're trying to go to the ritual room to get the Holy Grail book and place it in the area where we need to place it and activate the Bone Dragon fight. And in here, you need to do the helmet splitter on this pressure switch, although it's not a pressure switch if it doesn't stay down. Okay, so when I was talking about the iterations of the imps, I was actually speaking about these guys as the first iteration, and these guys are the weakest ones. They have that little jab that they do with both hands. These guys don't slide, so these are the first and easiest iteration of the imps. So, you know, the first generation of imp, and they're very easy. They don't slide underneath you, as I said, and they don't have hardly any body armor, so they're very thin, and they can be destroyed easily. So I know I fast-forwarded a bunch of footage up here, and I just can't recall, you know, because what I did exactly. But I know if I was doing that grinding for money to an excessive degree, I probably was going to fast-forward the footage. So these battles here, these are, I want to say they're optional. Probably, yeah, they're optional. You know, you can just go in this door without any problem. You want to grab this item over here, $15,000 that would cost in the store, so you definitely want to get it. And this is all sped up footage, just because I'm doing the same thing over and over and over again. So they got hornets right out the bat, and you're going to have some heavy-duty foes coming out of the woodwork. Completely optional a little later on, but this fight over here is mandatory. This fight here. So, whenever there's one of these archers of these... I don't even know what the hell you'd call these guys. But whenever there's an archer... there's usually one with with a bow and arrow. So you want to dispatch him right off the bat, because as long as he's... somewhere, you know, trying to hit you with an arrow, you're always going to get interrupted during your charging. So this is I think if you grab the Holy Grail, you can lead. No, I'm not sure. I know this is a mandatory fight, suffice to say, but a little later, as I'm slaying all these guys, it's optional, so you don't have to do this. But I would recommend doing this. You see, I did grab the Grail there. So, this is that. Okay, so we have an archer there who spawns a couple of times, or maybe just once, and we got some of these undead guys with a mace, and this guy on the other side with a bow and arrow. So, and we also have a dragon skulking around. He was not here on very hard mode, so they just threw this guy in here on very, very hard mode for us here on Master Ninja mode. He's brain dead. He will just walk into the walls like he has no brain in his body. It's funny. The thing about him is, they just kind of threw him in there. He can tail swipe you, but you don't really have to worry about him, like, trying to bite you or anything, or getting very aggressive. So he's just walking into the wall right there. And I apologize if anybody wants to watch this in real time, but, you know, this is going to be a 24-hour upload, and since I didn't fast-forward the Fiend Challenge, I can't leave this in real time. It's just, you know, kind of a balancing act of trying to make this video an acceptable amount of time. I don't expect anyone to sit through this entire video unless you're extremely entertained by me, which is awesome. That would be cool to think someone's sitting at their computer or laptop or iPhone for an hour. A lot of videos I just watch on my iPhone. I don't want to stay on my computer all day. So in here, more of these guys, and this is kind of funny. They just kind of like fall out of these little holes. Sometimes they'll just fall into like a sack of like dead laundry. It's pretty funny here. So at the end of all these battles here, you notice I'm doing one move over and over and over again. That's because I'm trying to get as much money as I can. And at the end of this whole battle, I think I had almost $90,000. So it's definitely worth it. Because once we reunite as Ryu after the next Rachel stage, we're gonna need a lot of money. We're gonna need a lot of items. So this is the best thing to do in preparation for the next stage with a long sequence. It's the stage with the red eye and blue eye and the Hydra Cubus and a long period where you have no checkpoint and in which you need to do a lot of stuff, and there's no opportunity to save it. And if you don't do all the stuff, like kill all the enemies, you really run the risk of missing out on a lot of money and a lot of items. So, yeah, this does take a long time, and it's got to be one of the longest levels if you're focused on doing everything. And it's really important to get that Diabolocro. I would say it's not that important to get the Spirit of the Devils, but sometimes it's nice to have a little more Nimpo to use. It really is nice. So you see right there, I had $83,000, and I spent all my money, but maybe I didn't spend all my money, but I didn't get all the items. Sometimes it is a mistake to buy too many items and run across chests that you can't get because your inventory's full. This part I detest with every bone in my body, and I refuse to do it with anything other than Nimpo. It's so irritating to get knocked off here and lose progress, so I don't mind wasting Nimpo there whatsoever. That part is so irritating, and it drives me crazy. So we're backtracking now up to this area where we originally started off in, and to the save point over here, and to the area where we did a little platforming and we got that Golden Scarab and the Life of the Gods, and where I mistakenly interacted with that area that we needed to insert the Holy Grail. And actually, when I was doing this, I wasn't even aware. I didn't know where this video was going to end because I was mistaking the starting point of chapter 9 for the ending point of this. So I was kind of, I didn't even expect a boss. I knew there was a boss, but I was daydreaming or something, and I just ran into the boss. So I don't even think I saved it, but I had more than enough items to handle the situation. So this Bone Dragon, this fight is fair because you can't really fall off the ledge that easily. If you're doing like flying swallows and Azuna drops, you would think that they would kind of throw you to the dogs with this ledge issue here, but it's really good. And normally I just do the Azuna drop to do a quick combo, and right there I avoided getting bitten, but I know I get bit somewhere. He does grab me. It takes a lot of damage away from you. So it's a Bone Dragon, and he does that arm swipe right there. He also throws those projectiles at you. So right there I got bit. See how much damage it takes away? You could potentially get killed. So you pretty much are going to get killed if you get bit, if you're like 3/4 of your health or lower. So using the Nimpo works pretty well. See, so if you want to just throw Nimpo at this guy, it would be cool. He will run his tail along the ground, and he did it less here than he normally does. Sometimes he'll do the tail swipe at you quite a bit, and you cannot block it, or you'll get hit. It's one of those things that I really don't agree with. I think if you're blocking his tail swipe, you should at least be able to block, at least with you getting your guard broken. That would be more of an acceptable, logical thing. You simply can't block it, or even if you're blocking it, you're just going to get hit. You're not going to get like your guard broken or something. It doesn't make much sense. So I like to stay on the left side. Right there, I got hit with it, that damn tail. It's pretty hard to dodge. So I like to stay on the left side of this bone here. It seems that you can get a lot of more hits with the Azuna drop on this guy. So if you need help, kill hornets and just keep doing the Azuna drop. When the bone changes color, it will change color in a moment. That's when you can't hit the bone. So that's just one area of weakness. So damn, this was a long, long video. So that right there, if you try to hit the bone right now, you wouldn't be able to damage him. So you just kind of wait till it heals itself or whatever. Not sure what's going on with this Bone Dragon. But there's a Bone Dragon in Sigma 2, which I don't like these Bone Dragons. They're not that interesting. I mean, they're kind of interesting concept, but I just don't find any enjoyment in fighting them. You know, take your pick. Whatever you like in this game, you like. And I'm not going to say, you know, you shouldn't like it because personal preferences are purely subjective. So I don't know how I dodged right there. So I got my due course for getting hit right there. So almost going to take this guy down. We took him down, and I appreciate everybody for hanging around. And he's almost dead. So I'm going to render this video. It's going to have to render for about 6 or 7 hours, and then it's going to have to be in the upload cache on YouTube for about probably 24 hours. So I'll see you then. Thanks everybody for watching. Make sure you subscribe and comment at your leisure, and thumbs up my videos. Thanks.